Sejin here. In today's video, we're diving deep into one of the top alternatives to Midjourney. After extensive research and hands-on testing with the most popular AI text-to-image platform out there, I've discovered a gem you might not know about. Whether you're new to AI image generation or on a hunt for a more affordable Midjourney alternative, this is for you. So stick around to the very end. Trust me, you won't regret it. So if you like this sort of content, please make sure to like the video and subscribe to this channel. Let's dive right in. I'd like to introduce you to Playground, a trending image generator and editing platform that's creating quite a buzz in the AI space. Now, I'm going to give you three main reasons why I think Playground might just be the ultimate Midjourney alternative as of today. First reason, it's almost entirely free. Although not 100% free, it offers an impressive free tier. You can generate up to 1,000 images daily and even use them commercially. Sure, there are some limits, but they're barely noticeable for most users. Second reason, user key experience is key. For those new to Midjourney, it can feel a bit overwhelming. You've got to download Discord, add Midjourney to the server, learn all the commands and features, and generate images through a quasi-browser experience. Playground, on the other hand, is a whole lot easier in my opinion. Just open your browser, log in, and voila! A spacious, intuitive virtual workspace ready for your creativity. Minimal typing, maximum productivity. My third reason is the tools and features galore. From draw to edit, simple eraser, and object eraser to advanced features like instruct to edit and image to image, Playground has it all. It's not just about matching Midjourney's tools and features, but about presenting them in an easy to use interface in an organized manner right at your fingertips. Let's dive in and you'll see what I'm talking about. Getting started is super simple. First, sign up. Once you're in, you're greeted with a beautiful gallery of images generated by creators just like you. It's not just a visual treat, it's a goldmine for inspiration and learning. Each image showcases its prompt and the nitty-gritty technical details behind its creation. Let's click on Create. You'll find yourself in a dark, minimalistic, clean workspace called Canvas. You have what's known as Generation Frame, where all images will generate in. Easily adjust its size by dragging the edges, or you can hold down Shift to resize proportionally. You can even manually input the size you want in the image dimensions box. Below that is the prompt box where you can write in your prompt to generate your image. You can move around the workspace by holding down the space button while click and dragging your mouse pointer around. You can hold down Control while using your mouse scroller to zoom in and out. On the left, there is something called Filter. This basically lets you create your image in different styles with a click of a button. Super perfect for people who need help coming up with different style ideas. You have styles like watercolor, realistic vision, playtune, retro anime, Play-Doh, and the list just goes on. Pretty impressive, huh? Below that is the exclude from image. This basically is the same as negative prompting, where you instruct the AI to not include certain details or qualities during the image generation process. Let me copy and paste my list of no-nos into the box. I'll be sure to leave this in the description so you can copy and paste it. Now back to the prompt box. When prompting, it's recommended that you include the following details like the subject, background, surroundings, and actions. I'm going to use the following prompt for this tutorial. At the bottom here, there's something called number of images, where you can actually select how many images you would like to generate at once. Let me select 4, which is the max number of images you can generate at once. I'll choose the second one and delete the others. You can delete the image by clicking on the trash icon, or you can click on the image and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Let's take the same prompt and use a few of the filters. This one is the watercolor filter, this one is a storybook filter, this one is a Playtoon filter, and this one is a Spielberg filter. Now let's look at the prompt guidance and quality and details tool on the right. Again, Playground made this user-friendly so you can slide the slider tool back and forth to choose your settings, or you can input your values. The prompt guidance basically controls how much influence your prompt has on the image. 0 has no influence and the max is 30. Here I've generated 4 images using different prompt guidance values to show you the difference. Here's prompt guidance at 0, this one is at 10, here's a 20, and here's at the max 30. You can see that as you increase the value, the images become much closer to the prompt. Of course, this may vary depending on the image. The recommended prompt guidance is a 7. The quality and details controls how much detail you want in your image. 10 being the minimum means you want minimum quality and details, while 150 being the max, you want the highest quality and most details. Here, I've generated 4 images using different quality and detail values to show you the difference. Here's an image with a value of 10. This one is at a 50. Here's a 100, and here's at the max 150. Here you'll notice that as the value increases, so does the quality and the details, but the last one with the max value of 150 looks very different from what I was expecting. The recommended prompt guidance is a 50. So the key point is that higher values don't always mean better, so you'll have to play around with the setting until you find something that's just right. With the images you've generated, you can always right-click on them for various options such as flip horizontally, flip vertically. You can even upscale it to 4x and download it or place it on Canvas, which is your workspace. Now, if you want to use any of these images for print, click on the link that's popping up on top if you want to learn how to upscale your images for free. Now, I want to go over some of the cooler tools you can have a lot of fun with. Let's look at the eraser tools. There's two types. The simple eraser and the object eraser. You can also control the eraser size for better control. The simple eraser simply erases any area you want to get rid of like a regular eraser. The object eraser is like InPainting where you can delete objects within an image and still keep the image's integrity. Pretty cool, huh? The next tool is the Instruct to Edit tool. You can have it auto-segment objects within the image and prompt in how you want to change it. Or you can manually draw on parts of the image that you want to change and then prompt it. Awesome! Because the Canvas workspace is shareable with other people you invite into the workspace, you can leave comments here and there for others to read. Now I'm going to show you outpainting. You can expand your image by using the generation frame along with the prompt. I recommend a frame size of 512 by 512 since it's best to outpaint small portions of the image one at a time for better results. Simply take the generation frame and move it slightly outside of the image area and click Generate. You can always insert a different prompt to change the outer image's look. You can also crop your image to make it more even. You can delete the background and overlap it with another image. Right-click on the original image and click Bring to Front to bring the image to the front. If you select both images and right-click, you can lock the shapes in. Locking it will lock it in place so you can't move it. Or you can copy combined images. When you copy combined images, click Paste to combine them into one image. If we look at the left panel, there's the image-to-image tool. To explain it as simply as possible, this is where you upload an image that you want to use to influence your image prompt. The image strength goes from 0, meaning it has 0 influence, and the max is 100, where it will have 100% influence on the image. You can kind of guess what that means. I'm going to use the image to influence by image prompt. Here is the first image with an image strength of a 0. Here it is at 50, and here it is at 100. Any image you generate on your workspace, you can click on the image to image icon to use as inspiration for your next image generation. On the right panel, there's what's called a seed. Basically, any image that's generated has a seed number, kind of like a unique identification number, which you can use as a reference or make iterations of it. So if I took the seed number from the original image I generated, uncheck the randomized seed value, and input the seed number from the original prompted image, I will generate another image referencing the original image. I can also change the seed number to generate variations of it. There you go. On the bottom here is what's called a sampler. Basically, samplers give you deeper control over the generation process to help you achieve subtle differences in details. In other words, because images are created from noise, sampler is used as a denoiser, which creates subtle variations in the images. The Euler sample produces slightly softer images while the DPM sampler is slightly sharper. The differences are negligible. While Euler and DPM is the most popular, I prefer the Euler Ancestrial. We've covered a lot today and I genuinely hope you'll explore Playground for yourself. Well, thanks for watching the video until the very end, and if you enjoyed watching this content, please consider giving it a like and subscribing to this channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.